at noon. Let's listen into the management at Tata Steel. My colleague Neha caught up with MD and CEO of Tata Steel on their expectation from Modi 2.0.
I think obviously the first focus will be on fixing the economy, getting it started again in a good way that it was, and we look forward to that. And I think I'm sure there will be a focus on the rural economy as well. So we look forward to the new team setting things in motion, which I'm sure they will.
So liquidity is seen as a big focus area, a big problem area at this point. What measures do you think the government will need to take at this point to correct this at the earliest?
I think over the last few months, the RBI has already taken a number of measures. I think that's good. I also think that the whole NBFC issue is starting to clear out a bit. And maybe there'll be more discipline in the market after that, but probably in the long run you have a healthier bunch of NBFCs, and which is good for the economy. So I think overall it's good. I think the FDIs are also coming in. I'm sure private investments will also pick up in the country.
From the steel sector, so anything in specific that you're looking out?
Well, the government, the BJP in its manifesto talked a lot about infrastructure. I think if they get on and invest in the infrastructure, that's fantastic for the steel industry, both from a demand point of view and from a cost efficiency point of view.
Moving on, let's quickly take a look at the crude oil prices and the level it's perched at as well. Definitely, it has cooled off a significant amount. It's near the four-month lows. Brent crude is down 19% from the April highs. So another important data point there. It's been the biggest monthly fall for the crude oil prices in the last 6 months. U.S. energy firms see a rise in oil rigs for the first time in the last 4 weeks. So that's something that one needs to keep an eye out for. Now, why the fall? Global slowdown seems to be something that's weighing in on the crude prices. It's the trade war, weak macro, which are hurting the crude prices, bringing it down to a near 4-month low. That's the update on the crude oil prices. I think